She's an award-winning stage actor, a regular on our small screens and Three's West Side as Carol O'Driscoll. Now she is reprising the well-known role of Nora in A Doll's House. Please welcome to the cafe, Sophie Hambleton.
Yay!
It's really quite difficult to recognise you without your 80s back home thing going on from West Side. When did you finish shooting that a while ago, didn't you?
Yeah, in February. Yeah, middle of February we finished, so it feels like ages.
But it must be coming out pretty soon.
Yeah, a couple of weeks.
Good.
And you were a big fan of Outrageous Fortunes. What was it like getting the call up to go on the prequel?
Oh, it was awesome. I was devastated when Outrageous Fortune finished because I was like, oh, I'm never going to get a chance to be on it. And I sent a tape up from Wellington to Auckland and a couple of weeks later found out. And
Wow. Yeah,
it was awesome.
Awesome.
Yeah. And even better because you get to do it in 70s and 80s
gear. Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't get much better than that.
Yeah, sort of the origination of the Westy Bogan, lots of leather and lace. Very tight.
And a good understanding of the Westies.
Yeah,
life, which I think
class.
Is good. Good when you go to parties.
Yeah, totally.
Which is always handy.
Good, awesome. And you are back on stage now as the lead in a very well-known Ibsen play, A Doll's House.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me a little bit about that and your role.
So I play Nora, as you said, who is the wife of the story. And it's basically about, like, if you tell a lie to protect someone that you love, how far can you go with that? And if you get caught, is it justified? Are you innocent? Yeah, when you do something that you think you're doing to help people that you love and it turns out actually to maybe not be so great. A woman's role in the household and the running of the household. And
has that changed over the years?
Well, you'd...
No,
we hope so. We can vote now.
There
is that. The play was originally performed in 1879,
right.
So very different for women back then. I think now we can have our own money, we can have our own careers, but who's ultimately responsible for the children and the household and... each dynamic of each kind of relationship, I think, is different.
Everyone is responsible for the children.
Well, okay, so given that, then, how is the play so popular still and relevant in this era?
Well, I think it still raises some really interesting questions about how far we have come with equality and, you know, at the moment where it's very hot, feminism and pay equality and women's rights and things. So it sort of enables us to maybe have a look at how far we think we have come and how far we actually have come. And
nice.
Yeah.
It sounds really good. Who else is in the show with you?
Arthur Meek and Francis Biggs, Carly Corpi and Peter McCauley.
And has Emily Perkins, writer, has she changed any of it for this version?
Yeah, it's set now. It's set in modern day times. That helps us kind of access the story
right.
a little bit more. And some of the names are different. And it's totally different.
Set now as opposed to into 1879.
Yeah.
We have a couple of different things. Like we can vote.
And wear pants.
And wear pants at the same time.
No, but that's a good thing about doing a play like this,
totally.
I guess, is that you can showcase all of that, which
totally.
Is fantastic. Okay, so you do theatre, you do TV,
mm-hmm.
and you do film.
Mm-hmm.
I know actors hate this.
I like this question.
Yeah. Do you have a favourite out of the three?
The money is definitely better in screen, I have to say.
Right.
So that's nice.
Yes.
But I do love the live element of theatre, of every night it's completely different.
Mm.
Once you start, you can't stop. You fluff a line,
keep
you can't
on
go,
going.
Oh, sorry.
I know that feeling.
Can we stop and do it again?
Yeah.
We'd like to be able to do that.
So you have that exchange with a different audience every night. It's very, very alive.
Do you get different vibes off different audiences?
Totally. Like one night something is really funny to one audience and the next night you wait for the laugh and it doesn't come.
How is that possible? You've got such a big group of people.
I think it's just people are so different and sometimes if it's a smaller audience, they're sometimes shy about laughing or communicating. So you need that one person with a... crazy big. Laugh to encourage them into it. But it can be anything. Yeah, we could be a little bit off or a bit different.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay,
you
cool.
need me at your show.
Yeah, you do.
My man laugh.
Yeah.
No, excellent work. Love it. Good work.
Cool.
Thank you so much.
Thanks so much. And the Chapman Trip season of A Doll's House plays at the Circa Theatre in Wellington from August 5th. For details, you can go to the website circa.co.nz.